So hey guys, I just got a real quick video here. First of all, if you haven't registered to win the LED light bar that I'll be giving away, the one that changes colors, go back, view the video, answer the question, send me the message, and get your name in the hat for the running on that one. If you've already sent me a message and you have the answer to the question, then I'll actually do my selection on Friday, which is the 27th. What this video is on today is the light bar I decided to go with, and I don't know which one I'm going to keep. I'm not really going to run both of them, but I'm either going to run this one. This one's made by Nylight. It has floodlight on the side and then spot beam in the center. This one's super bright, but now I have this one that I've recently got in, and it's an Auxbeam, but this one has a really unique characteristic. So a lot of people like to drive around with their light bars on, which in essence blind everybody. This one actually has a daytime running light feature, where right in the center of these diodes, there's another diode, and it only illuminates a cross shape here in the center, and this is actually called the cross series by Auxbeam. So I'm going to turn it on real quick so you kind of get an idea what it looks like. And again, it has a daytime running light feature, which is much dimmer at night, and it's a lot safer per se. Let's say you're going to be in the fog or in the rain and you just want some extra light, but you don't want to blind oncoming traffic. So here's a light bar with the daytime running light feature turned on. I'm doing it in the sunlight here because at night, even with the daytime running light feature, it makes the whole light illuminate. So I want to be able to let you see these parts. You can see the little cross shapes here. And only because of these center diodes are you getting that light. The main LED lights aren't on right now. But at night, it gives you a tremendous amount of, you know, ambient looking light. It doesn't actually flood the area, and it's not blinding to oncoming traffic, and even during the daytime. But I could see these being really nice if you're driving in inclement weather or fog. Now here's what the light looks like with all the LEDs on. So you have the ability to either go with just the cross daytime running light lights or with all five lights in each pod. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4 plus the middle one. And I can turn the middle one off too if I want it to be just slightly dimmer. Now here's what it looks like one last time. And this is with the four main pods on, but the center daytime running light turned off. And this is still exceptionally bright. So let me do a comparison. I'll turn this light bar on as well. Okay, so now I have both light bars on. And what I can tell you is it actually appears as if the Auxbeam light is a little bit brighter than the Nylight bar. Again, the Nylight bar has a diffuser built in to these outside pods, so they're more of a flood beam, and then the intersection is a spotlight. Whereas the Auxbeam, they're all slightly diffused, but at night it casts kind of a forward beam, so it's not a floodlight, but it's not necessarily a spotlight. If you're just using the cross section or the daytime running light section, it looks more like a floodlight. It looks like it illuminates a much broader area. But again, it's still not blinding or glaring to oncoming traffic, which is really nice. If you think I should run both of them, let me know. I was actually thinking of removing one and just running one of these, but I want your opinion. So let me know. Do you want me to run two of them? Do you want me to run one of them? Do you want me to run the Auxbeam or the Nylight? Or should I just scrap everything and get a rigid? Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this short video. If you do, I'd appreciate it if you like and subscribe. Thanks, everyone.